for the beginning of the session. So I would hand over to Cedric. A warm welcome to you, and thanks a lot for presenting.
Yeah, thanks for having me. Welcome to everyone. I hope you can see my screen already. I can't. So now, yeah, take some time. So sorry, it's a bit laggy. I hope the app will look a bit fluent, not as yesterday. So I'm going to talk a bit about building a modularized Shiny app as we did for our Coreate X Challenge contribution, which won. So yeah, as mentioned, I'm a freelancing data visualization designer. I'm also a scientist at the Institute. And it's very laggy. So let's next slide, please. Okay. So first, this nice picture comes from an artist called Benjamin Lacombe. And just want to name him here because I really like his artwork and I don't want to steal it. So give it a try. It's very, very nice books. And the Golem package I used for this, or we used for this Shiny app, we submitted and which was presented yesterday. Unfortunately, a bit laggy, as mentioned. So I will give it a try now and do it as well online. Show them online. Oh, it takes long. Okay. Or I jump to. Oh, not even the slides are reacting. So. Sorry for that. Oh, no, too. Okay. A lot going on here. Okay, now it's loading. While it's loading, it takes some time. So this is some of the drawbacks currently of the Shiny app because we have a lot of data. It's about accidents, reported accidents of cyclists in Berlin. It takes a while to load, but this is how it looks like. We have these slideshow. So each slide has a content, and we have some interactive graphs, which, as I said, take a while to load because of all the data back there. So in there we have some line charts and some bar charts, and also some interactive maps, and that's what I want to show you, how to include these and which packages we used for that. And now it's taking a bit too long. So I will directly jump to our example, which is this one. So there are bar charts like these, which are interactive. So you can click on the legend and remove these categories. And I also added some buttons here, so you can change the data you want to look at, or also the design of the bars, which I found very interesting because there's always this discussion, which are better Dodge bars or stack bars, and I like that the users can choose on their own what they want to look at. And the interactive map looks like this. So we have a Cloudpath map and one map showing lines for bike roads and one for accidents. So here we are going to focus on the Cloudpath map. And if you click there, you can get how many accidents we are on bike infrastructures, which district we are looking at, and the total number of accidents. Okay, so that's the aim. Now back to the slides. And loading. And all the code for this challenge is also on GitHub. When the link will show up. Sorry for that. Not sure why it takes so long. Okay, so yeah, so this is all also on GitHub. So if you want to have a look at the full map, on the full app we submitted for the challenge, you can go there and the full code, but I also provide a repository with the code we are working on today. And also this takes very long. So there's, as you know, for GitHub repository, you have used this, I assume, in an advanced session now here. There's all the code. You can clone the repository and run the app on your own and modify it. Okay. So first, which packages did we use? So we use, of course, Shiny because it's a Shiny app. And the interesting part here is that There's a golem package, which allows you to make easily use of a modularized Shiny app. So it provides a framework for you, which you have to fill. Then the full page package, which allows you to have these slideshows, the eCharts 4R package, which allows you to have these interactive bar charts, line charts, and also maps. The TMap package, which is for interactive leaflet maps. And Shiny CSS loaders, which is just a tiny tool to give you these waiting points while the graphic is loading because it took that long.
Cedric, one short question is already in. Could you post the link quickly so the others could follow?
Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt you.
Which link? So that's the link to the repository.
I think she meant
here. Here's a link to the app. I hope it works better when you're not sharing your screen.
Great. Thanks a lot.
And the one for the repository will follow in a second. Okay. Every time from the beginning.
I'm very sorry that the technical stuff isn't working too well. I don't know why Hopin has so many issues.
Yeah, it seems one slide he doesn't like, the one which follows after this one. Here it always stops, kind of, and then it, okay. Okay. Good. So the first one is Shiny, which we use as the basis for this. So just a short introduction to Shiny for everyone who doesn't know. So there will be also the intro to Shiny session in an hour. So Shiny is an R package which allows you to build interactive web apps in R, which then are translated to HTML code and can be shared as standalone web apps, but also included in other home pages as dashboards or in R Markdown documents and reports. And what the good thing is, or the nice thing we make use of here, is that you can extend these Shiny apps not only using ggplot or base plotting in R, but also HTML widgets, which often use JavaScript libraries, and also design these things with CSS themes, which you can actually also do for R Markdown reports if you like to. So if you want to change the colors and the fonts of your R Markdown reports, that's easily also possible. There's one book which is currently in writing but finalized soon, which is Mastering Shiny by Hadley Wickham himself. So if you want to try it out, it's a free online book, an open access book, and will be published by O'Reilly. And in general, a Shiny app can be very simple. So this is already a Shiny app. This is the first example he gives in his book. So this is the Hello World example. So a Shiny app consists of a UI and a server function, and these both then are wrapped together with the Shiny app command, just as a short overview. And you can always, I hope the GIF now works, you can always open a Shiny app or build a simple Shiny app in RStudio by going to New Project, Shiny Web Application, and you already get a bit of the structure for a Shiny app. Which is, there are different ways how to build a Shiny app. And as we are here talking about modularized Shiny apps, this one is not a modularized one. So as in the slide before, all the code is in one script. As your Shiny apps become more complex and grow larger, you can use modules to manage the complexity. So because if you have several slides of these, so each slide has a code for each chart, for each map, for each content, it will be difficult to have all in one script and have thousands of lines. So the good thing is you can modularize this. And this is where the Golem package then comes in. Because if you want to create this from scratch, you can do this, of course, by coding, but you can also, the same as we did now with the RStudio new project, you can then create a new golem, which then already sets up this modularized version. So how does modularized Shiny apps work? We have modules, which are called mod R usually, or mod something R, where there are the functions to create the things and display them, so the server and the UI functions. And you have a server and a UI script also separated in which you, on the server side, you call the modules, and on the UI side, then you connect these and show whatever you want to render. So you can have one module and then call it several times. So if you have always have the same line graph for different things, you can use the same function. So this is really like using functions. But you could also have several functions in these modules, or split these functions then into two modules or several modules, which you can call. And this is usually how you do it. So you have for each kind of, either slide or thing you want to build, you have one module and then you call it in the server and the UI respectively. And this is how this looks like. So there's this new thing, which is the namespace. I don't want to focus on this. This is something you need, and it will not work if you don't have it. Golem will take care of this for you. If you write it from scratch, it's likely that you miss it. I did it and searched for the error 2 hours because it would simply nothing show you, because it doesn't know where to grab the modules from. So it's really like to linking the modules to your main app. Okay, so the Golem package was mentioned already. This is a very, very nice framework, an opinionated framework that they state themselves for building production-grade Shiny application, and basically allows you to set up the project, but then also to create modules, to add packages to your documentation, and in the end, even to publish your Shiny app on the server to make a Docker image out of it, or to make it a package, an R package. So also they have a book which is called Engineering Production Grade Shiny Apps by the people who developed the package. It's also open access on engineeringshiny.org, and they will walk you through in general how to build Shiny apps for production grade Shiny apps, and also a lot of the Golem package, of course. Okay, so you can install Golem from CRAN or the recent version from GitHub if you like to and want to follow here, but maybe the best thing is to do it afterwards. So the same as we did before in the new project, after you have installed the package, you can create a Golem in the new project directory in RStudio. And there will be then some output like this. So it will first tell you that this is a way to build a Shiny application, a production-ready robust one, and that there are three files they provide in the development folder, which is the start, the development, and the deploy. So these are the three different workflow steps you have to, and they will support you to manage these steps in a simple way, hopefully. Okay. Next one. Waiting for the next slide. Okay, so this is where you on GitHub, github.com/coralcon2020. This is where you will find the repository for the example app we are building now. So if you want to do it on your own, you can go there. So you can either use Golem and fill it out yourself and learn the coding, or you can clone this repository. Seems hyperlinks are the problem. Each slide which has a hyperlink takes hours to load. So next time, no hyperlinks. Huh. Sorry. Okay, waiting for the next one. Okay, I will... Since there will be a lot more hyperlinks, I will switch to the PDF and hope this will work better. No. Okay, let's do it like this. Maybe this is a bit faster. Okay, where are we? Here we are. Okay. And okay. So if you open then the first file of these, the 01_start.r script, it will tell you what to do. And as you can see, it will really walk you through everything you have to provide for your package or for your app. So this is basically when you're also developing a R package, what you normally give as metadata in the description. So the package name, the package title, the authors, and so on. And they have comments back here also to help you what to fill in. Sorry, this is another. So here is a version. So this is the filled out. So in our example, I already filled this in. If you start your ones, of course, you put in your credentials and so on. And it has also several other functions in the same script. So it will set the Golem objects. You don't need to take care of this. Then you can add licenses and readmes and code of conducts, batches, news. You can directly link it to your GitHub repository and also create a template for testing later on, which then will be tested with Voxygen 2 and DevTools. You can change the favicon, and in the end, it says you're now set, and then you can go to the development. So this is where your kind of like your documentation, your first initial steps are done. Then you, when you go to the folder where you created this one, this is how it will look like. So we set up a version control. We have a development folder where there are all these scripts are laying in that I showed you now, the start dev and deploy scripts. These are the usual folders you know from our package development, files that are made available, then the package documentation, the scripts, the modules, the testing, and a lot of metadata and the RStudio project files. When you then jump to the next one, this is the development script. There you basically build your modules and the whole app. So the first thing is that you can use this use package to add some packages you want to use, and it will directly add it to the description and the namespace file. So it makes sure that they are contained in your Shiny app and your package in the end, so they will be installed and all necessary functions are imported. And the core thing here is the add modules one, which is very helpful. So there's a Golem function called add module, and then you simply type the name in. So we are going to have two ones here, hopefully, in the few minutes we have. So a bar chart and a map. And when you run these, it will directly create a file, which looks like this. So it will directly create a template where it names already the functions. It puts in these namespace thingies, which you likely forget. So this is the UI part of it. And on the other side, there's also the server function. And the nice thing in the end, it also provides the code you need to copy then in the server and in the UI scripts. So where you directly call it. How this looks like, we will see in a minute. So I created two modules. One is the bar chart, one is the map. Both look more or less the same. They just have different function names. And as they suggest, we copy the commented commented lines at the end into the server and in the UI. So here the module bars is called and gets a name to refer to, and the same for the map. And in the UI, we have the render functions, and it calls basically the render functions from these two modules. It has also a lot of other helper functions. I don't want to go through these, but you can add CSS files, JavaScript files, and data sets. So for the raw data, for example, it will create an R script, which will be directly put in the data raw folder. So you have the script to prepare your data, and it will save your data in the data folder as an RDA. So you even document the steps you need to clean up and summarize or aggregate or whatsoever your data for the app. So you even have the development steps of your data cleaning, wrangling inside this project, which I really like. And also, this is all automated. So if you do this, you generate the script, and the script has a command in the end, which adds then the data to the data folder. OK, I will go on a bit faster because we're running out of time. So this is a Docker images and how to deploy the app in the very end to the Shiny server. Then there's the full page package, as I said, for the slideshows. So here's just a demo, which doesn't work now because we're on the PDF. But this is basically what you have seen in the example, that the slides are going upwards. There are also other frameworks where you can go to left and right and bottom and top, so all four directions. again, in the app server, we copied these call module thing. So they will refer to the modules. So this is on the server side. And the same we do on the UI side. And here on the UI side, we have to use the full page package then. And this is how it looks like. So you basically say, OK, we want to use full page, and then how they are named. And then each slide gets a page section, and there you refer to the function where the bars are created and the maps are created. So how do we create these bars? There's a nice package eCharts for R, which transports the eCharts library to R, as the name says. So just to give you an overview, the eCharts library is very, very, very nice one and very inspirational because they have many, many different also more uncommon data visualization types. So you can see on the left hand that there's a lot. There are sunburst graphs and even 3D things, maps, a globe, a 3D globe, which you can rotate, and all this stuff is already built in. And you can simply access this, all this functionality in R then. So this is the package, which was built by John Cohen, and you can use when you have it installed. So how does it look like with inside our module now again? We have what the Golem package already provided. And inside, we create the output, so the output bars, and we render it with the eCharts function, render eCharts, so as you do it with Plotly or any other tool you use. And inside, you need the data. We need to group it by type. And so the type is here. I didn't show you the data. The type is which traffic category, so cyclist or car or pedestrian, and then it will draw one bar per Gemeinde, per district, and map to the bars the accidents. So how does this look like? This is what I showed you here, and now it's gone. So the run development script you use to test your Shiny app, and now it takes a while again. Not sure, normally it takes 20 seconds. Okay, here we go. Hopefully. Okay, next time I take a screenshot beforehand. Since it's about interactive graphs, I thought it's nicer to show you the interactivity, but okay. Please. Okay, I will come to back to this in a minute. So just to show you shortly the TMAP before we take some questions. So I also have some other functionalities here. So you can then also, the defaults look very, very nice, but then you can even modify the things as you know from ggplot. So you can add with a pipe all the things you want to change. So here we change the axis a bit because we have overlapping, because the district names are very long. And you can also add very simple a zoom that you can zoom in into your graph and that you can have a look at the raw data and that you can even download the raw data. These are things which are already built in and easy to add. So let's take a look at the app again. Okay, now it's loaded. So these are the toolbar thingies. So you can zoom in, which will be likely very slow now. Oh no, works. And go back out of the zoom. You can have a look at the raw data. And this raw data also depends on what I have chosen here. So if I deselect the pedestrians and the motorcycles, these are not contained in the data, I hope. Oh, they are. If you have buttons, which I also have a script for, but we will not cover here, then it will also not contained in the data because it's filtered beforehand. And again, you can have these interactivity things here with basically four lines of code. And this is the default look. So I didn't beside changing the labels here, rotating the labels because they were that long, this is the default look. So the colors, the lines and everything, this is how it looks like. And I think it's very pleasant for default thing, especially if I think about ggplot, which I'm not a very big fan of the defaults of. Okay. I will jump over this and just want to quickly show you the TMAP thingy just to show you what's possible. So TMAP is a great package for mapping, and why it's better or why people prefer it over ggplot, for example, is that you can have multiple shapes and layers easily. It's very easy also to facet it as you do in ggplot, and there's an inbuilt leaflet support, so you can make it interactive even in your RStudio session very easily with one line of code. And you can use this then in the Shiny app as well. And I will skip how you do this, but show you the example in the Shiny app. Sorry for that. And as you have seen before, so also here you can change then the tile maps you want, the base maps you want to have included. It's interactive, so you can zoom in and out, and you can click on these as shown before, on these things, and get tooltips, which you can then prettify and stuff like this. So it's a very nice thing, but there are several other packages which you can use for mapping in Shiny. And that's how I will want to end this thingy. So I will skip all these. Sorry for this. And there are many more packages you can use in general for HTML things in Shiny or R Markdown. And here's a list of resources of interesting packages I find interesting. And if you look for maps, there's also leaflet map, the map deck, and the map view packages, and so on and so on. So it's a rich community which is growing and growing. And I really would recommend you to also have a look at the JavaScript for R book, which is not yet published, but also online now since 2 weeks or so, which is written by one of the main developer of many of these packages, and makes a very nice link to JavaScript and how maybe you can build even your own package to transition a JavaScript library to R.
Great. Okay. Thanks a lot, Cedric. And very sorry for the technical issues. I hope the others can just find everything they need in your repo. Thank you for providing the link here.
Yes, please. One note for this, for the repo, because I didn't cover it now. As I said, I also have a version with buttons in there. So if you're used to GitHub, I have a second branch which is called Buttons. And if you go to this, you will, while you take questions, I will load the app and show you that I also have code for a bit more advanced
thing. Thanks a lot. So if you have any questions, please just write them in the chat. I will ask them to Cedric then. Of course, if not, you can just write him later on using direct messages in Hopin or Slack.
Yeah.
I think this goes without saying.
Of course. Of course. Also mail, Twitter. I have it all on my slides. And the slides are also available on the GitHub repository in the manual folder. So if you want to have a look at the slides again, it's also possible. And I hope it will be ready in a second here. So we can move on to the next in time.
Let's hope it's like
that. Yeah, I just want to, I mean, this was a bit fast, but I think the value of the Golem package is that you can really make it simple to build these modularized Shiny apps. And even you are building simple ones, I would definitely recommend to use the Golem package, because it also has these, all these documentation steps. You don't need to build from scratch or write from scratch. And also the way it handles with the modularized Shiny apps, it's really a nice concept once you got into it. So. But this is not a Hopin specific problem. I had the same things with Zoom as well, okay. That sharing Shiny apps also somehow. I mean, I even have a quite fast computer here, but yeah, okay. So then you have these buttons we also have seen in the contribution. So here, for example, you can choose different data sets or, as I said, dodged or stack bars. And for the interactive map, also different data sets, which I simply load in and then just have an observation function which updates the map, but which is, of course, what Shiny is good in. So if you want to check out how to do this, it's not really a magic about, or not really differing from from other shiny maps, but for everyone who didn't
do this yet. Great. We have two questions in the chat, perhaps one sentence or two sentences each for the answer. So the first one, do you have any tips for deploying shiny apps?
Yeah, this was actually a pain. So a lot of time in the challenge went into this because so as you see, it's very slow. Now it's hosted on the Coral 8 server already, but also there we don't have enough capacities. So if several people enter, it takes time. Also the HTML widgets are not always optimized. So this is something I want to work on. So there's the Leaflet GL package, which they say it's very fast, so let's see if this can speed up the things. So I hosted on shinyapps.io, but not without problems, and also Docker image. But I also got in contact with the people who developed the packages because there were some tips and tricks you needed to follow because something just didn't work. For example, the projection library on the Shiny Apps EO server is a different one from the one you usually use locally. So you need to turn them in a different projection beforehand to make them able to be the maps displayed on the Shiny Apps server.
I believe this sounds complicated. Great, thanks a lot. And the second question is, so is Golem in your mind always preferable over a simple Shiny app, or are there any special cases you might also prefer a simple Shiny app?
Yeah, I mean, if you really build a shiny app, like the first thing, the Hello World example, like where you have one plot and two buttons or something like this, or one slider, like these really, really basic examples, I don't think a modelized shiny app makes a lot of sense. But as soon as you move into data preparation and having two, three or more tabs or slides, I think it's valuable. And I mean, the modelized Shiny app, as I said, like it's not necessary that you use Golem. So you can also build a modelized Shiny app on your own. Golem is just there to help you to automate the process.
Okay.
But I think the modelized Shiny app, I mean, you never know where your app is developing. So I think it's good to start from this and then build on that on top. But yeah, if it's really one plot for your supervisor or whatsoever.
Of course. Then there might be a bit too much overhead. Okay, yes. Great. Thanks for your answers.